Alright guys, welcome to tutorial number 3, and this tutorial will be covering the tools, panel, window, whatever you want to call it. Now, before I start, I have an announcement to make. I know for some people, the basics might be a little bit redundant, especially if you have some knowledge of Photoshop. Some people don't, so I decided to make this tutorial series for those people who are starting out and want to get into it. However, I have also decided, instead of postponing my videos for the more specific stuff, such as thumbnail making, logos, game assets, so on and so forth, I decided I'll post those videos as well, so the people who kind of have an understanding or have an understanding of Photoshop can begin and start doing, you know, what they want to do. Second announcement for today is my upload schedule. So the long-awaited update of the schedule. I am going for a post a day or a video a day or two, but rarely three, depending on how pumped I am to upload, because sometimes I really have an urge to upload something and I'll upload it, but it's usually around 1 to 2 uploads per day, and hopefully I'll be able to keep that going for a long amount of time. So today we have the tools window slash panel, whatever you want to call it. We're going to be doing an overview, so we're not going to go into the nitty gritty stuff of every single tool. We're going to go over basically the most common tools used. We can get those punched out of the way, and then we can later get a little bit more specific in future videos. So, if you haven't watched the last two tutorials on the layers and the windows, check the description. I have a playlist going so you guys can easily browse through that and get to the tutorials as well as the Ground Zero video. Alright, I haven't said this in the Windows tutorial, the Windows panel tutorial, but if you want to open up the tools, all you click is Window, you go down. It's already checked because I have my tools opened up, but if it's not checked, you click it again, it appears there, you got your tools panel. Pretty cool. So, we got the tools panel. This is where all the tools are. So, let's begin. I have this rounded rectangle on my canvas, so I can use it as an example. First of all, we got the move tool. You can easily move stuff. That's pretty cool. You're probably going to be using this all the time. Next, we got ourselves the elliptical marquee tool. You might have something else. If you want to see that, all you do, there's this arrow in the corner. You click and hold, and you got these tools, and you can release on one of them, and it'll change. Now, this is the rectangular tool, which I use the most. I never really use the elliptical tool. But, you know, there are times where I need to use it. Single row and single column marquee tool. Again, I don't really use these. But, you know, it depends what you do. You do different things. So, yeah. Now we got the lasso tool. Now this is, I love the lasso tool. I personally use the polygonal lasso tool the most. If I'm lazy, I use lasso tool just to get like the basic area. But if I want to get really, you know, detailed, I got the polygonal. Like I said, if you see this arrow, you click and hold, and you got all the tools, as well as the short key, shortcut key. So L will be the shortcut for those, M for these, and V if you just hover over the tool. V. All right, now we got the quick selection tool. I usually use the wand tool. Click and hold, wand. Quick selection is basically, you want to get an area real quick, you just use it as a brush and cover that area you want, and sometimes it can be a little buggy. And then we have the wand tool, which I love the most. filler. Okay. We have to rasterize this. There you go. There you go. So now we have that area selected. Cool. The crop tool. All right. Instagram. Let's do it. So if you want to size your canvas down, just grab one of these corners and move down. As you can see, it also shows the dimensions in inches. Or if you want to make the canvas bigger, you just drag it out. There you go. And just click enter, whatever, and you'll have that cropped. All right, now we have the eyedropper tool. Basically, all you do with this tool is select colors. Love colors. You can also go to the swatches and do the same thing. All right. Now we have the spot healing brush tool. I won't be going over these in this video because these are a little bit more for detailed work for specific stuff, which we're not going to be going over. We have the brush tool. Brush tool is a godsend. I don't know why I said that, but I love the brush tool because I'm a digital painter, and brush tool like every day. So basically the brush tool is used as like sort of brush. So if you want to make some crazy design, look, it's toothpaste. That's what you use it for. With the brush tool, if you want to do digital art, I recommend getting a tablet, a drawing tablet, like a Wacom or Huion, whatever. So now we're going to skip these two. Basically, this is the stamp and this is the history, and you can go into there. This will just undo your stuff. You can just Control Z if you want to undo your stuff. Eraser tool. Wow, we have this really terrible looking rectangle with crazy Trump hair. Let's get rid of that. So we just bam, eraser tool erases. Now, I haven't said this, but up here it has the options for these tools as well. So like the brush tool has options. You can adjust the brush. You can select your preset for the brush, and you can change the hardness. You can make it super hard. You can make it super soft. As you can see, huge difference. You can change the size in pixels. Great stuff, great stuff. Eraser. So let's make this eraser 100% hardness. Let's get rid of this bad boy. Cool. Now we have nothing. Oh no. Bam. I don't like the color white. It hurts my eyes sometimes. So let's get the paint bucket tool, and we're going to fill this whole empty layer with purple. Love purple. Not being racist, but I love purple. So we also have the blur tool. Oh, that's not going to help, is it? Let's get this color. Now we got the blur tool. Just use that as like the brush. All it does is it blurs. Sharpen tool. These are pretty kind of self-explanatory. Just always mess around with these tools, because the best way you can learn is just to mess with it and get a feel for it and then start doing stuff with it. So smudge tool, smudges. So you can do some sort of crazy thing. Dodge tool, burn tool, and the sponge tool. You might be using this depending on what you do. A lot of tags or signatures use these tools. So burn tool basically makes it nice and bright. Oops. Or the dodge tool. I get this mixed up. Then we have the burn tool, which makes it darker. So you can see. Interesting, interesting. Sponge tool. There you go. It's like, these are more like specific stuff. That's why I didn't want to go over it, because it might seem a little too much right now. But the pen tool, you need to know the pen tool. The pen tool is the pinnacle of design, because if you want to make dank logos, pen tool. Never use Photoshop for logos. Use Illustrator, but pen tool. I'm going to have like a separate tutorial for pen tool, because pen tool is just Jesus. So basically, it's like the lasso tool, but you can make these nice curvy and then these crazy edges and stuff like that. And pen tool is used to make logos, and yeah, it's just, you need to know the pen tool at a very good level. You need to be able to kind of easily kind of flow it and get things done. Best way to learn, like I said, just mess with it, get a feel for it. And if you right click over the area, you can make a selection. I usually do this, or use the fill to fill it with a color. There you go. Cool. Control D if you want to deselect. The text tool. All you have to do is either drag out the the area where you want the text to stay inside. So I want to stay inside here. Hello, YouTube. That's great. Nice. You can obviously drag these corners to make it bigger or smaller, your box. And if you don't want to be restricted by a box, you want to stay outside of it. All you have to do is just click once and then type what you want to type. YouTube. Oh, that's not how you spell YouTube. YouTube. Oh my god. YouTube. Here we go. Cool beans. You can also click and hold. We got the vertical type tool, horizontal mask, and the vertical mask. All right. Now we have the path selection tool and the direct path selection. We won't be covering these in this tutorial. Later. We also have the shape tool. Now, the shape tool is basically what I use to make that rounded rectangle, like this one. All you have to do is, if you want a different shape, we got rectangle, we got rounded rectangle, we got ellipse, we got polygon, line tool, and the custom shape tool, which when you click, you'll have a menu up here. You click it, now we have a whole selection. Let's get a paw. Bam. Best design on earth right here. Cool. Now we have the hand tool, which basically you can use to kind of move around if you're zoomed in. Very cool. I just use space. When you use space, you can get the hand tool going. The zoom, I like using shortcuts, so I do control minus or control plus, control minus to go out, control minus to go in. Now we have the colors, which you're going to be using. Right here, if you want to switch it back to black and white, or you want to select a different color, you just click in this box, you select, or you can just hover out and select one of these colors in your canvas already. And you can go to the other one. So let's say I want to get stark purple. And to switch these colors from, you know, this is the primary color, this is the secondary color, you just click this right here and it switches it. You can also click X to switch them around. And yeah, thank you guys for watching this. Like, comment, and subscribe. Like I said, these might be, for some people, it might be really basic and stuff like that. I will be coming out with more specific tutorials, so stay tuned for that. I know this video was a little bit longer, but there's a lot more to cover. Hope you guys enjoyed. Peace out. Bye.